Hey guys, and welcome to the final episode of my vegan build series. Okay, so here it is. Since the last episode, I have done some paint fading on the mid-green areas, decals, and after that I put on a gloss coat, did some weathering, added flat coat, did some additional weathering on top of that, and after that I did the final assembly. But as you can see, there is something missing, and I don't know if you have noticed it, but the pitot tube on the nose cone or the front radome is missing. And in the last episode I was very surprised that I didn't have any issues with that, but I during decaling I accidentally dropped the model into the bench and I broke off the pitot tube, and after that I glued it in with the CA glue. And as you all know, that the CA glue is very brittle, so that meant that if I basically only touched the pitot tube, it broke off. So during the end of the build here, I had something like 4 or 5 incidents where I broke off the pitot tube. And the last one was actually during the photo session. So that is why I haven't put it on back yet, because I didn't want to delay this episode, because I will have to order a new one and put there. When I was taking the last photos with the aircraft sort of belly up, I accidentally knocked off one missile, and when I tried to fix that, I broke off the pitot tube and it went ping away. So it's somewhere here in the basement, but I have no idea where it is. So I have stopped looking for it, and I will, as I said, I will order a new one. Okay, but let's have a closer look at the Viggen. I have to be very careful here, because everything is CA glued in all directions, and it's very easy to knock off parts. But I will try to be very careful, so I don't make any stupid mistake here, live on the camera. Okay, if we start with the faded areas, I thought a lot about this, and after looking at reference pictures, I saw that the mid-green color did the most fading, and I still wanted to have some fading on the aircraft or the camo scheme, but I didn't want to have too much, because I want this to be a sort of relatively new aircraft, sort of a Viggen in all its glory. And so I didn't do much weathering of the other areas. So what you can see here is the mid-green ones, they have a little bit of yellow in it, just to simulate fading. And also I'd also did some shipping on the leading edges of the wings and the canards and the tail fin, because they have a black lining, but the edges are often very sort of shipped with, so the bare metal is shining through, and the same story on the air intakes. And after that I did the decals, and they performed very well, no issues at all. If you look very closely to the crown marks here, you can see the Swedish Air Force insignia. You can see that they are a little bit out of register. I see if I can, but it you can barely see it with your naked eye. You have to look in close in, or in a macro photo shot to see that. So what more can I say? The The flaps on the main wings and the canards are slightly drooped, like they should be on a sort of geared down vegan. And I also have attached the upper petal of the thrust reverser, so it's very hard to see the details inside the exhaust here, but you can see that it's slightly drooped, and that is the same story with that. When the hydraulic pressure is released when the engine is shut off, all the sort of hydraulic operated areas sort of droop too. And another thing that is characteristic for the Viggen is the tip of the nose cone. And I know it looks horrible without the pitot tube, but I want to show this anyway. As you can see, there are two sort of matte coating on the radome, and the tip is gloss. And the reason for that is that on the real aircraft, the tip is made from plastic, so it's a different type of material, so it will weather differently. And I have tried to replicate that. So if we continue with the underside of the aircraft, I've done some weathering around the sort of areas around the mid of the aircraft. Because of the thrust reverser, a lot of dust or dirt collects around these areas. Not so much out on the wings, but also you can see that there are some additional dearth around these actuators here, because they seem to collect some dirt as well. Okay, and there you have the missiles and the rails. It was really, really difficult to fit everything and to get it in place. And I think I need to make a couple of adjustments on the 3D model for the rails to make them fit better, especially for these Skyflash or RB-71 missiles. Apart from that, we have the main landing gear. They are quite complicated. See if I can show you that. And we also have the interior of the main landing gear base, like so. And we have the REM air turbine. Like so. And we also have the front of the I did some scratch building on the nose landing gear strut and added some wires and stuff. And yeah. And finally, if we look at the cockpit, you can see that I have added one detail here, and that is the black with the yellow stripes. That is the safety handle for the ejection seat. So when the ejection seat is in safe position, then the handle is pointing forward, and when the pilot enters the aircraft, he folds that back into the, you see the recession between the headrest and the upper part, so it gets out of the way. And that is actually a 3D printed part as well. So there are three different 3D printed parts on this kit, the two rails for the different type of missiles, and also the safety handle. And I have done some scratch building on the IP combing, or the area under the windscreen. There is some defrosting lines or defrosting tubes at the front. I don't know if possible to see it. It's very difficult to see, I guess, because of the glare from the lights. And there's also a small, I think it's an optical sensor for the head-up display. So it sort of picks up the light level or the light intensity of the horizon, and adjusts the intensity of the head-up display too, so the pilot get a good contrast of the information on the HUD. So yeah, I think I have covered everything, and I will carefully try to put this down so I don't break anything. And this has been a quite long build, I would say, a very complicated one with a lot of scratch building and not so much aftermarket, but a lot of other stuff that have taken a long time to do, and also the painting is quite demanding, so it has taken a lot of time. I think this is something that it's more than 4 months that this build has been going on. And during this build I have done a couple of things, I think, that is quite new, or things that I can share with all of you. And let me just put that aside, and I can. We have the different 3D printed rails, and I will share the STL files for this, so everyone can download them and print them. And I have also the safety handle for the ejection seat. I see if I can get this in focus. It looks like this on the ejection seat, like that. And I have also made a masking set for the. I'm using my Silhouette Portrait to cut masks. So this is a complete set for the JA 37. But you can of course use it for other vegan versions from Tarangus and Special Hobby as well. But for the SK version with two canopies, you need to have sort of double of these. So I will probably, when I make the SK 37 myself, I will probably make a new version of this with all the extra masking parts for the canopies. So okay, and I will share that on my Google Drive or something, so it's possible to get hold of it. I will add all the links for this in the description of this video, of course. So, what's next? Well, I will start a body build again with my fellow modeler Chancer NW, and we will build the Polish trainer TS11 Iskra, and I will show the kit 1 second. So it's this kit, and I will start a new build series with this very soon, probably next week or early the week after that, but I have some other things that I need to finish first. I need to make a reveal and a build and reveal video for the Viggen first, so that will be probably be my next thing to do, and after that I will start with this. So okay, thank you guys for watching, and it's been a really fun build, this one, and I'm very pleased with the result of the Viggen. So until next time, take care, happy modeling, and I see you soon. Goodbye.